All right, so this is a recording session on how I take a classic R&B song and make it into a smooth jazz song. Now, I might get the video blocked, but this is for educational purposes. So I'm doing this to educate. Therefore, it falls under the fair use copyright law. So I shouldn't have the video blocked because I'm doing it for educational purposes. All right, so here we go. All right, so the first thing I do, I'm not going to walk through every single step, but the first thing I do is open up a new Logic Pro, don't call it a session, but I open up a new file, a new session file. Pro Tools call it a session. But I open up a new file and I bring in the song that I'm going to cover. Most of the songs that I do are existing songs, so therefore it's not hard to find the song. And usually I already have the song in the library. So once I bring in the song, there's couple of options I do to make the song. It's a loop. I want to loop each section of the song so I can learn it. So usually I will start with the intro because oftentimes for songs the intro is the same as the verse. Not all the time, but the intro is usually very similar to the same progression that the verse is. So I will start with the introduction. Now this song, like I said, it's save it's a You Give Good Love by Whitney Houston. I remember exactly where I lived at the time that this song came out. And I don't think I've done any other Whitney Houston songs that I can think of offhand until now. I may have added some of her music to my list, but I don't remember actually making a smooth jazz version of her music yet. So here is a classic song. So I never know the key of the song. I never know the progression of the song until I loop it. And then I'll play along with it so that way I'll know how to record it myself. So let's get going. So this program will do some amazing things. It can actually tell me what tempo the song is and actually align it and set the tempo automatically. It's very effective. It doesn't work 100% of the time, but I've been learning how to use the tool a little better, so we're going to try to use it right now. I want the program to take the song, tell me what the tempo of the song is, and then put the song in that tempo. In other words, make the song loop automatically. So we only need 4 to 8 bars when you're looping. You need 4 to 8 bars. So we start on the one, which is the kick. So I want to go from the kick to a kick. So from 4 bars to 8 bars. I say 4 bars because I don't always need 8 bars. 8 bars, for those who don't know, is a typical hook, a length. And the key is to have you hear my click, you hear my tempo, metronome going. The key is to have that metronome locked. Now, there is some caveats to that, meaning if the song was not done using a sequencer, or if the song was played a live drummer, then the tempo is not going to be consistent. And there can be some drift, even if it was, because if it was going to a reel-to-reel tape, the reel-to-reel tape might slow down or speed up because it's not a computer. So I've had to learn how to adjust. But this program can actually make the adjustment. So it can actually align it. It'll sound a little funny, but I'm not trying to align it to play the song. I'm trying to learn the progression of the song. So I need it to be on time. How it sounds perfectly, that's not the unique, that's not the goal. The goal is to be able to let the song play over, the part play over and over again. But like I said, if the computer is automatically trying to align, you know, the snare and the kick, then sometimes it sounds a little funny at that part, but it's usually not that noticeable. So let's see if the computer can do it automatically. And then if it can't, then I'll do it the other way. There's a manual way that the computer, that this program allows you to do it. So I'm trying to do it the easy way, but there is other ways to do the same thing. So it's only a 4-bar intro anyway. So I know where it ends. So remember I said 4-bar or 8-bar. So now I know it's only going to be 4 bars. And so I know exactly, I'm going to mark it. So I'm going to mark it. So now I only have the exact amount that I need. So I need the tempo to adjust. Now I could just change the tempo until it fits, but that may not always give me an accurate, it won't always line up in sync. So anyway, so here goes. I'm going to use the feature. So we're going to use the tempo. And then you have some options. It says, apply the region tempo to the project tempo. So basically, I'm saying use the WAV file and change the tempo of the program, which that's what we want. The other way is you can apply the project tempo to the region and downbeat. So what that means is you want the loop that you have to conform to whatever beat you have. So you could do it from the file to the program, or from the program to the file. Adjust tempo using regional London. Okay, and then there's another, like I said, there's another way. So we're going to do one thing first and see if it works. We're going to go apply region tempo to the project tempo. And now it's asking me, this function applies to the tempo of the selected region. The region, obviously, is, they just call it, it's a, the file, the song, the region, they call it a region, to the project tempo. It can also align the region to the downbeat. So it basically, it will try to align it for me. So that's what I wanted to do. But that's not 100% necessary, but I always try that first. So here we go. So it's calculating, it's analyzing. All right, so it shrunk it. So let's see. See? So it seemed like it did it, but it didn't align it. So I'm going to just slide it over to align it. So now it should just loop from the first bar to the fifth bar. Even though it's 4 bars, it goes all the way to 5. It goes to 5, but it's 4 bars. So here we go. See? Now, that's just the intro, so that's not going to help me because it's just basically staying on the same note, probably. It's not really doing anything here. It's staying on the same note. So I need the verse to come in. So now I'm going to extend this to include the verse, because the verse is what I'm going to need to loop to do the song. The beginning is not helpful in this particular song. So we're going to start here. And so I'm gonna have to do it again. I'm gonna have to mark it again. So I'm going to mark where that bass starts on the verse, right where I can see the actual file. I can actually see it on the waveform. This doesn't have to be 100% accurate because we're talking about milliseconds, and some of this you won't ever notice, but the more precise I am, the better loop I get. The more precise I am, the better the loop will be. So let's see. Since it found the tempo pretty much before, that tempo may have never changed, which is a good thing. Meaning I kind of know where the tempo is, somewhere between 75 to 76 beats per second, beats per minute, BPM. See, we almost there already. We're just gonna stop there. Now that was really an odd number for that portion, because that's really seven bars where normal songs would be eight. So that's weird within itself. I see what it is. It's really a break. So it's four bars with a break. Looking for one, two, with a two bar break. So it's really four bars with a two bar break. I see what happened here. One, two. I'm a drummer, so I'm kind of like, you know, it's counting that's involved here. Took some time for me to see. Alright, so we're going to stop it there, right at the verse. I mean, right up their hook. I found out what I've been missing. I found out what I... So it must be a different timing. So I have it as 4/4 time, but it has to be something else because it's not lining up. I found out what I've been missing. Actually, it is. On the run. I've been looking. Every downbeat is another measure or bar, which is good. Here go 8. So it's 14 bars. not 16, so it's too shy of what is normal. So this song is different. I run into this every now and again with older songs. It's not always 4 bars or 8 bars. It can be an odd number, like 6 or 7 bars. I'm trying to see if I want to keep this a 4-4 time or not. Because it's going to greatly, it's going to affect everything that I do. So I need to make sure this is the right timing. I'm gonna try something different here. I changed it to a 3-4 time, and it didn't mess anything up, which is kind of funny. I think I'm just gonna leave it at 4-4 time. Seems like I got a good loop. So this, all I'm doing is preparing the song for me to learn the song. And it's a step that it's gonna make things a lot easier if I get this right. I found out what I see. So it's a little bit off, so we're going to run that program. We're going to run that function again because I didn't do something right. I didn't align it correctly. Let's see if I aligned it correctly this time. I think I got real close. Like I said, it doesn't have to be super perfect, but it does have to be somewhat, because if not, then it's gonna feel real weird. And I can see when it's off, and you know, I can look at the waveform and see that it's off or in sync. It looks a little off. Meaning the tempo changed at some point. Now it looks like it's on again. So that's enough for me to learn the song the way that it's looping now. And that was the whole purpose. So now I can try to figure out the song. Now, usually I would arrange the song and know where the hooks are and all that. I'm not going to do that at this second. I will do it, but I'm not going to do it right now. What I want to do is figure out what key the song is in. I'm not going to write anything down. I usually write things down or whatever. Lately, I haven't been writing it down, but because I figured I didn't need to. So usually I would write down the song name, I would write down the key, and I would write down the progression. I found out what I've been missing. So first things first, we're gonna save it. P12. So we're gonna save this. This is going to my 12th album in this series. I have lots of albums, but this is a series of albums that I'm creating. I probably won't live long enough to do all these albums because there's so many songs. It's a lot of songs. But that's my goal. Okay, you give good luck. You give good luck. So I'm saving the file so I can come back to it later if I need to. So I gotta figure out that progression. So it seemed like it's changing. So I don't wanna get confused. So I am gonna write it down because it seemed like it's changing. This may be one of those challenging songs, or it could be a very simple song, and it seems like it's challenging. I've been looking for someone. I found out what I've been missing. All right, so let me try on the piano and try to figure out the key, and then I'm gonna grab the bass and try to follow the bass line. Once I get the bass line, I'll be able to get the chords. So I'm gonna take the beginning, the in sections. Alright, so I'm gonna write the song name. Alright, so I wrote the name, and now I'm trying to find the key. Always on the run. I found out. right now, it could be E, E major. So it seems like it's out of tune, meaning it's going to be a little harder because the song, like I said, if it's tape, it's going to be a different speed. So my perfectly tuned digital keyboard is not in tune with whatever they were in tune with. So trying to find the key is going to be hard. It's going to be a little harder. And I've ran into this before. And sometimes I'll try to tune my piano to the song. In other words, I'll make my piano go out of tune to try to match. That doesn't always work, but sometimes it does work. I have to figure out if it's out of the easiest way to do it is to use my string instrument because it can go in and out of tune very quickly and try to figure it out that way too. My dog is barking. He wants me to feed him. And he's in the next room. So if it's in the key of E, it's starting on a 1.
bet you that's the six. Yep, so 1 to 6. So 1, 6, 3. That I'm guessing, right? So then I fine tune it. I'll say, okay, that's not right. And then I fine tune it until I get it right. So remember, it's detuned, so it's hard to hit the exact note, but I'm trying to hear it. 1, 6, 3. So they went down on that bass. And they probably went to the 2. Let's see. All right. 1, 6, 3. No, they just went down an octave. So it's 3 and just went down an octave on the bass. 1, 6, 3, octave. Okay, so that's it. So now what I'm gonna try to do, I'm going to try to tune my keyboard to what they were using, which is gonna not be easy because I gotta figure out are they high or low. So we gotta go to the keyboard settings, and I gotta remember how to do this. This is something that you would normally not do. All right, so let's see. I gotta go into the settings of this computer, of this keyboard, and let's see. Exit out. See, my dog is barking because he wants to eat. All right, so we say, let's see, EQ. Oh. So we need to, first of all, the studio is pretty dark. I need some light. I don't really do this all the time. So, and then it a lot of functions are on the top of a keyboard, but the tune function is usually not on the top. Transpose and octave is here, but not tune. So we're going to look for, I think I can go to, let's see, is it utility? Yeah, so there go utility, there go the tune, there it is. So normally this is something you wouldn't do. But it's here for a reason, right? So what did I say? Let me see. Okay, so that's it right there. So we need to tune, let's try tuning up. So I'm gonna go 1 at a time. I'm gonna go 1 increment at a time. So that don't sound like that's right. I don't think I'm going to get it perfectly, but it's going to start sounding different. And I could be going in the wrong direction. So we're going up. Now I'm going to go to 3. I'm going positive. So it seems like I'm making it worse. So we're going to go backwards. So we're going to down tune negative. Okay, so we're going to go -1. -2. I found out what I've been missing. Always on the run. I don't know if it's getting better or worse, but it might be getting better, so we're going to go -3. I found out what I've been missing. seem like it's getting better. And then there is other ways that you can do this. They have other software where you can figure out the actual frequency or key. But some of the stuff, it'll just give you a general key of the song, not the tune of the song. But I'm sure there's some program that can tell me exactly what the song is tuned to. But you can hear that it's not right. So, therefore, their tuning is different. And I guarantee you, it has to do with the 24 channel or, excuse me, the 48 track. They probably went to tape. They went to a high-end tape, but the tape speed will fluctuate. See, I went way positive, just guessing, and it seemed like I think I got it. It's 8. I went plus 18. So then I'll write this down so that way I can put the keyboard back to the right tune. Or if I forget and the keyboard doesn't go back to the right tune, then I'm going to be off next time and won't remember. So that's going to help me figure out the song way better. So we went plus 19. Doing the scale on purpose so that way I can find the chords that they're using. So this is where harmony comes into play, where it's hard to explain, but that second chord is really the three chord, not the six chord. So it's a 6/3. All right, so. So that's a 1/1.
I've been missing.
that's a six with a three chord, and then that's a three with a three. That's it. So you can invert certain chords, even though it's the same chord, you can invert it and it'll sound like a different chord. So that's what I tried to do. So I basically played the same chord, but I inverted it the second time. Basically playing the same chord but inverting it. So that sounds like they did a one over. A one over the three. So I haven't changed the chord yet. All three notes was the same chord. Okay, so you can see my hand doesn't move. My right hand won't move. One over three. Six over three. Three over three. So I didn't change, right? So that's all I'm doing so far. Okay, so so we gotta, first of all, we're gonna write down, for now, E major is the key, all right, for now, and then we said for bass, not necessarily the chords, for bass, and then we're only on the verse, so the verse and the intro and the hooks and the bridges may be different, so we're gonna write verse one. So far we have one. All this can change. This is my process of trying to figure it out. All right, so one, six, and three, and then a three octave. So 1 6 3 3. So it's not exactly the same chord. It's the same texture of the chord, but they changed it. I can hear it. Right, so it's then what is it? Okay, so let's figure out what I just did. So we did, in my opinion, 1, 2, 3. So we did over the one, we did a three chord, which is a minor, a flat minor, and then I did an inversion. So let's see what inversion I did. So that's 1. So I did a second inversion of that same chord. That's really the three, but just inverted. So it could go like this. That's the same chord, but they use different textures of that chord. And the last one is different, but they did it that way. So I'm going to go 3, and then I'm going to write first inversion. Okay, so same chord, inverted. And then that last one. So then I got to identify what this is. That's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a 5. So it went 3, 3, 5. Okay. So 3, inverted 3, and then a 5. Okay. And in that case, the 5 is the B. B major. Okay, so here we go. So I already know what that's going to be. It's going to be a 1, 2, 6. Right? Looking for someone. It's gonna be something like that already. I mean, you can hear it. Someone. Alright, so one thing at a time. So here we go. So bass is that, but that's not the chord. I'm getting ahead. All right, here we go. So we have in the bass, 1/3. Here go the 1 in the bass, 3 on the chord, and then a 6 on the bass, and then an inverted 3. It's kind of better than going, right? So instead of going, they went, which is the same chord. Root, first inversion. Root, first inversion. So I got to figure out the chorus there. So now I'm ready to move on to that part. So we got one part out the way.
I found out what looking for someone. Looking for someone.
So what I'm doing is I'm slowly going up the scale to try to find the chord. I know the bass is E, but I gotta find the chord. So I'm looking for a major or minor chord that's gonna fit that.
Thank you.
So the bass is not the one like I thought it was. It seemed like it's six now. And this would be impossible or harder to do if I hadn't tuned the keyboard, so I didn't even write that down. So the tune, special tune, it would have been hard for me to find these notes, plus 19, so that way I can remember. It would have been so hard to do this if my keyboard wasn't in tune with this song, because now I can hear exactly what the note is. I used to play at a lot of different churches. I make it seem like I don't go to church anymore. I haven't joined a church in a while, but I would really marvel on how long it would take them to figure out. Well, no, some of the musicians could figure it out without doing what I'm doing, but what I'm doing is making it a lot easier. But they wouldn't use the song, and they can't hear when you play the music out loud through loudspeakers. Sometimes it's hard to distinguish what the notes are and what the bass. So this is the easiest way to dissect the song and figure out what the notes actually are. But I've seen so many churches struggle to try to figure it out, but playing the song, the part in repeat, in a loop is the easiest way. So it is what it is. So looking for someone. Okay, so that's six. So this special part, or this I don't really know what part it is. We're just gonna continue to call it the verse. It's just the ending of that section. So it's six. And then that's a sharp three, a flat four, however you want to call it. Sorry, that's just the four. I'm sorry. It's just the four. Six, three, four. So let's see if that works.
Looking for someone.
that is the 6. So let's see. Flat is 7, so that's the dominant 7. That 6, 3, 4, and then the chord, you could just do 2 chords actually, just really it's the 6 and then it's really just the 6 chord. So 6, 3, 4, so it's 6 and then that's really what's going on here. Inverted. 1, 2. Excuse me. That's the root. 1. Come on now. Root. 1. Second inversion. So it's the second inversion. That's the 1, but inverted to the 2nd degree. I keep going down, but it's up. So. Okay. Been looking for someone. Then it got. So someone. Okay, so now we're going, so that 3 is just a walk up. That's just a walk. I keep going down. Play the one, you could play 6-3 and play 1-1. But most likely you could just hold the chord. I keep going down. All right, so instead of playing three chords, I can play two chords. Like that, all right? So that's the one. So it's the one, which is the second inversion. And then there's a beat, basically. And then the four. And so this right here, instead of playing this, you're just playing just a part of that, which is really the six. So you're skipping the five. You're not playing the five. You're playing the flatted seven, the one, and the minor third. Because that's the real chord right there. But you don't hear that in that chord, so they only playing. Because it'll sound like this, which will work. So it may, let's see. See, I didn't hear the in there. Looking for someone. It'll work, but that's not what they're playing. Looking for someone. Now I gotta get that hard part. Bing, bing. So I missed a note. So it's a 1-5. So it's 1-5. So that transition. So it really depends on how you want to voice it. Right. So that's really what's going on. Here's another way to play it. Someone. But it's looking for someone. So really that's A. So four. So basically it's landing on a four. I didn't realize that was four. It's a part of six. Okay, but it all depends on how you look at it. That's why music is relative. So chords are broken down in two different chords. Two. So it all depends on how you voice it. And I talk about this in my book. So it's kind of funny that this chord is the same as this chord. It's just voiced differently. That's the same as that. Same chord as this, just an inversion Okay, so anyway. All right, so we got that. So 1 over the 6. That's the 6 over the 1. 3 over the 5. See how pretty that is? The reason why I couldn't do it up there because I had to share the same note, so I got to play it down lower. All right. I've been looking for someone. Makes sense, right? Looking for that's the note that she's singing for. That's the note that she's singing. Been looking. That's the note she's singing, see? So you can pick out the notes. I'm arpeggiating the chord. It was the original notes that I had said that it was. It was 1, 2, 6. 1, 2, 6. Looking for someone. I had picked those notes out already, but the chords is what I'm playing. So it's really, harmony is just really amazing, okay? It's just crazy how this works out. Looking for someone. So now everything makes sense to me. Song out of that, just arpeggiating that by itself. Right? All right. And then it goes, now you're here. So we got to see, we got to go back to, see if it changes or if it goes back to the thing that I've already mapped, so we gotta find that out. Now you're here like you've been before. May have changed to an E minor, I'm guessing. So try to figure out the gig. It's definitely not E major. Started on a G. You know now you're here like you've been before, and you know now you're here. So it went from E to G. So when I listened to, okay, before I knew about music progression, I knew, I wasn't thinking about all this, right? But as I started developing and understanding chord progression, I knew something was funny about the song, that it changed, but I just didn't know what the change was. Now, it changed to a different key. It went from E, 1, 6, 3, and then that, now you're here. It changed to a different key. It changed to G, and G being the one. So that one is a major G, to a minor E. So the E major, like I said, went to a minor. I said it right. It's not E minor key, but the E is now a minor, okay? So that's music theory. You see what I'm saying? So I was right in that sense, that the E that the key of the song is in was E major. Now it's E minor because of G being major. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then E is the 6. So this is all music theory. And then there go the 7, then back to G. That's how I knew that the key changed. So now I have to write here, G major. I wrote it in the wrong place like an idiot. Okay. So G major, okay. And then we start on the 1 of the G. We're not going to say if I did it in relation to the E major, it would be the 3. But the 3 is a minor in E major. So I can't call it the 3 because I'm in a different key. All right. So it gets kind of complicated. All right. So in the key of G, that's the 1. So we're going to put it in the key of G now. I'm gonna try to guess the next key. I think the next key is gonna be, I'm guessing, a D, which is 5. So I'm guessing that.
Yeah, that's a guess.
I was right.
Two beats for the 5. Once you get going and you understand chord progression,
what comes next seems very natural. So it's not like I'm a perfect musician that can play perfectly, but I do understand music. I do know how to record it. That's one thing I can say. I know how to record it. I might not know how to play it very well, but I know how to record it. 1, 6. So 1, 6, and then 5. That walk down.
Okay,
something like that. Okay, we're getting there, which is next, but let's make sure that this is right. Now you're here like you've been. So it even went down to three. So it went 1-6-5-3, I believe. I didn't catch that at first, cause I'm doing chords and bass at the same time. So I was wrong. I was wrong. So it went 1-6-3, not 1-6-5. That three, that did sound like it though. So it might be the chord, okay? So I got the bass wrong, but I think the chord is what I said it was. So let's see. So that's kind of helping me see what's coming. So I only just did the bass. So here's the bass. Now you're here. That's perfect, right? So we have two beats on a three. Okay, that's bass. So I'm writing that this is the bass. My dog is mad at me, but he didn't do what I told him to do, so he has to wait to eat. I don't reward no disrespectful dog. So six, three, three. Now you're here like you've been before, and you know just what I need. It took now you're here like you've been before, and you know just what I was right about the chord. I was right about the chord. So 1-6, and then what is this? A five over three. So I was right. Okay, I wasn't wrong. I was just saying what was the bass and what was the chord. I got those mixed up. All right. So again, where are we at? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, here we go. Is right. So here go, so that's one, then one to the six, and then it's a five chord. So the bass is 1-6-3-3, the chords are 1-6-5-5. That octave thing from that three to three on the bass. So that's something I'll remember when I do the bass. So now we do the walk down.
See you.
I know what the notes are, but I don't know what key this is, right? It seems like it's back to E. Hold on. It's still in G, which is good because it depends on what number I give. But I won't know until I put the chords to it. So that's a major. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's so far so good. So that's a minor. So that's right. So 6, 5, 4. Six, three, four. G major is 6, 3, and just because I write it down doesn't mean it's right. I have to figure it out, make sure that it's right. I need to at least write it down, then make the adjustment. So 6, 6, which is minor, 6, 3, 4. So 6, which is the sixth chord, 3. Which is the four chord, so that's perfect. Notice all these could be medleys of a song. Songs, right? Okay. All right. So that's the verse, and then I got to figure out the hook, which the hook seems like it's just more straightforward. It won't be hard to figure that part out. All right. So let's map that out. Let me see. Yeah, and then there's a change. Can't stop looking around. It's not what this love's all about. All right, so we have the verse, and let's do the we're gonna do the hook next. So we do the hook. The hook should be similar to. It usually is the verse, but it might be different. So I've seen it different before. So let's see. Now we gotta loop the hook. See, it's probably gonna be different. So let's see. It's 1, 6, 3, 3. See, that's not even close. So let's see. Oh, let me see. Oh, that's the verse, okay. So that's a whole different thing, Clay. Now let me find the key. So the key might be in G, and then the verse was just in E, which is fine. It doesn't matter either way, as long as you know where you are. So the song is probably not in E major. The verse is in E major, and the main parts are in G major. The way that I'm doing it, doesn't change anything. All right, so now I got to find the hook in G. So it seemed like it's 5. Section at a time. And there's no telling that the verse repeated, so it may be in G the second verse. So I'm just guessing here.
Thank you.
think he went up. So I'm getting two notes, which is the same note. They probably went. Down what I have so far. We got in the key of G major. Okay, so we have the one. What I have right now. I gotta find the chords for those.
Yeah.
might have my bass wrong. I think it goes straight to the A. I think that that's right. Let's see. Bass does it, but the chord don't. Okay, that's it. 1-6-3-2. Sounds so familiar. These chord progressions are the same from different songs. They sound different from the voicing, but I've done 1-6-3-2 a few times. All right, so here we go. The beat, the measure that I'm going with. All right, so. Then. All right, so that's it. So that's it. So that's the hook. Now we got to get that change part. We're going to call it the change. All right.
Baby, you give good love to me.
finished. I'm not finished, so. I think I already know what it is. I think it's two. I think it's two. I never did the chords. I never wrote the chords, okay? I never wrote the chord. Okay, so. So that's. Inverted the five. So here's the root of five. Five root. Here goes the first inversion. Second inversion. So it's a five. So it's a five. Second inversion. Five over the one. Six. It's just a six. Five, six. That's probably why I didn't write it, because the chords are pretty much matching. That's a three. Probably why I didn't write it, because the chords are matching. Okay? Alright, so let's go to the change. Not the change. It's the end of this part. Again. Here goes the second part. So instead of, okay, wait a minute, let me get it right. So that's, that's a flat seven. So you can call it diminished. Let me see. If it was diminished, it would sound like this. Okay, so it's a sharp five diminished. So really, let me see, let me try to get this right. F, okay. Yeah, so it's a seven, and a seven is usually diminished, but it's a seven major. So you basically plan a major where it would usually be diminished. So then you can say that it's a seven without, it's a major seven without flattening the three. You plan a natural three. and you're playing a natural five, right? Second time around. Here it goes. Okay, so. So it went from the seven to the five. Right, so it went from a seven major to a five.
And that's it, seven to the five.
So the first time around is I gotta figure out what that is. 1, 6, 5. So that's it.
Now I do the change. Now I can't look. Let's see if the
let's see if they changed on me. 1. So I think it changed on me, man. Flat 7, 6. So we're going to say on verse, and this is a complicated song, verse 2, we're going to go 1, 7, 6. Thank you. the melody, but that's not the bass.
I was always searching for that perfect love. You've been, be like you've been. Be
okay,
there was nothing. I was always searching for that perfect love. The kind that
I got the chords, now that I got the bass. See, the melody is 176, but the bass, the chords. So the bass on that little transition is 5. So I need to, instead of writing the change here, we got to go to verse 2 because verse 2 is different than verse 1. Thank you very much. So the first part is 1-6-3-3. Yes, it's that. But then on the second time around, it goes. First time around. So it just break down right after that. Okay, that's fine. Then it breaks down.
The kind that grew.
6-3-4. 6-3. Probably put the 5 over that 6. Mm-hmm. Let's see. I did it differently. See, I played it totally different. I played it totally different. I went 6-5-4. I did 6-5-4, which is totally different, but it still worked out. That's probably what it really is, but I did, which is the same thing. That's the same as going. So it all depends on how you want to voice it. Try the other way. I gotta find that last note, but So, 1-6-3-3, and then, so I wrote it as 5-3-4, which was wrong. So I'm going to go ahead and read all of that. Walk down. The kind that girls like you dream of. Never stopping, I was always searching for that perfect love. I'm gonna try to find that last note.
bass is doing that though. I was right about that. 6, 3, 4, 6, 3, 4, 6.
So the chords is 6, 5, 4, 6, 3, 4 is the bass. So I was right. It's crazy, but
it's like I'm writing the wrong thing at the wrong time, but I got it right. I just got to put them both together. The bass and the chords are different. That's a different chord, even though, so I'm playing it, I'm going down, but then it's really 6, 3, but playing a 5 chord, right? So that's what gives it that harmony. All right, so I won't have a hard time doing this song now that I'm kind of dissecting. But I want to just do the change, and then, in other words, I got 97% of the song, the verse, the verses and the hook. That's the majority of the song. One note here and there, I'll figure it out when I play it. So I'm really doing just like I'm doing a wide stroke, and then I fine tune it when I record it. That's definitely F.
Now you're here like you've been before, and you know just
Too many changes. I hate songs like that because it just makes it hard to keep up with what's going on. Now you hear what you did before, and I know just what I need. It takes a time to see.
Time.
So F major, then it goes 4-2-1-1.
It takes some
now you're here like you.
So now we get to that part because I already know that part. So
now you're here. Some time for me to see. Time for me, time for me to see. Time for me to see.
Okay, wait a minute. So if it's in the key of F, it's 2-1-2.
Okay, 2-1-2. So chords is 2-1-2 for now.
Thank you.
So the bass, 2, 1, 6, chords is 2-1-2. So it's going. Something like that. This song is very, very complicated. It's not simple. I mean, I'm figuring it out, but it's just not very simple. First, I gotta figure out what key it is. So remember, the song keeps changing keys. So we have F major there. Let's see where we're at now. So this will be the change. Okay, I gotta find a key.
It's not.
I pretty much know it. I'm not even going to really write it. I'm going to write it down, but it's not going to, you know, I'm going to figure it out when I record it. But it's, I said that it was B flat. It's all over the place as far as keys, okay? So it's six. Can't stop. So six to the five. Can't stop. So that goes to a. That's that. It's a seven. So, but it may not be diminished, but it's a seven. And it comes back. Figure that out, but I'm gonna write the basic stuff here. Six, five, then it goes something like that. I think there's a sharp five in there somewhere. I'm just gonna write sharp five, and then it tries to resolve on a four. And then four. So I'm just going to write that, and I'll figure it out when I record it. But I basically went through every part of the song. The verse one is different than verse two. I went over the hook. I know what the hook is. Usually the hook will stay the same. Even if it doesn't stay the same there, I'm going to keep the hook the same throughout the song. And then it has a different verse two, right? It goes to F major, and then the change, which is this one. And it's a lot of walking and moving. It's not hard to figure it out. It's just a lot. But I'm gonna try to lay the bass first and then lay the chords over it. And if I get the bass right, then the chords will fall in line. So it's easier to figure out the bass first and then figure out the chords that goes on top of the bass. So that's my process. I basically went through the whole process of figuring out the chord and the bass. It took me longer because the song changes. It's not a type of song that repeats. So it took me, what, it says 172.07. I don't know what that means. I guess that's in minutes, 172 minutes. I don't know what that is. So, you know, an hour, a couple of hours, 2 hours or whatever. But yeah, that's my process. I listen to the song and I dissect it. Now I can make my own little beat. Right, I can make my own beat, and then I can start playing the bass to it, boom, boom, right, and figuring out, you know, because I already have it written down, or I have a template written down, right? I have the majority of the song and the majority of the bass and the majority of the chords. And then when I go lead, I'll be able to compare the original to what I'm doing and say, oh, no, I thought it was a 3, but it's really a 4 now that I hear it, you know, that now that I'm playing it. I needed to do that in order to get the bigger picture. So that's my process. So hopefully it was entertaining and you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think. I'm out of here. Gotta go feed my dog.